Not only is Kickstarter ideologically bankrupt, but they support fraud. That's right. You report somebody actually stealing your work, and you know what they'll do about it? They'll do absolutely nothing. Now, the nastiest thing about a move like this, too, is it doesn't just hit the creators. I mean, that's bad enough. And you know what? Kickstarter, they don't like certain creators out there, so they'll actually ignore that. But consumers, they actually ignore their consumers. Here you have four backers defrauded out of $115. Kickstarter has actually been told about that. And you know what they say? Hey, we don't see any problem with that. Now, here's something that I'm wondering about this, too. Under their own terms of use, they have number 9, your intellectual property. And they say here that the person that posted it, they're basically promising that they're not violating anyone's rights or copyrights. Basically, we didn't know that that was transpiring. Well, you know what? They were told about this transpiring. They were told that 4 people are being ripped off. And they decided that that wasn't an issue anyhow. So this, the deniability factor, yeah, that doesn't factor in. So yeah, let's talk about this and let's have a little bit of fun pointing our finger and saying, you know what, you are to blame. So hey there, to all you fine folks, by the way, I hope you're having a pleasant afternoon. But beyond that, and I mean this sincerely, I hope 2021, it is treating you kindly. Now, as far as this subject goes, I'm going to ask you, share this on social media. Share what's happening. Make sure that Kickstarter sees it. Shame them. Get other creators to cover this stuff. Because you know what? It's absurd that Kickstarter will tell you that this, it's not a problem. Now, as far as this issue is concerned, I actually learned about this a few days ago, but silly me, I thought that this had been remedied, so I didn't follow up on it. Then I saw this post. Now, the person posting this, by the way, this is their book. I know that legitimately. I actually own some of this person's work, but beyond that, I know this person personally. They're a good person. They're a good creator. They're definitely worth backing. But they note this. Shadow of the Kraken is only on Indiegogo, so if it pops up on Kickstarter, obviously it's a fake. I understand that mentality, too. I will not back Kickstarter in any way, shape, or form. Some of the stuff they have pulled before, it is beyond horrendous. Then they tag in Kickstarter, which like I said, this noise, it needs to be amplified, so I would ask that you do the same, even though we'll see their answer in just a second, but at Kickstarter supports fraud. They let some nut copy my live campaign, have still never contacted me. Then they ask who the heck this person is right here. You know, who this person is that launched this, which we'll look at that in just a second. He committed fraud. It has been reported. DMCA sent. But you know what? That won't matter. The company, they have to take it down because of the country this is involved with. Basically, you can't get country to country to do anything about it. The platform, they have to do something about it. Now, if you're thinking to yourself, man, this needs to be reported, by the way, well, here's Peter Gilmore telling you it's actually been reported. Peter Gilmore, too, he's a great artist, but beyond that, somebody that I know personally, somebody that I worked with on a comic, somebody that I trust implicitly. So, this answer, oh yeah, he went in, he tried to get something fixed, and this is the answer to it. Hi there. Thank you for bringing this project to our attention. So you can see what was written here. The project, Shadow of the Kraken, you have the report date for January 15th, 2021. You have the time and on. Report content, it's an unauthorized scam, clone, copy of this project. So it shows you the reality of this. This shows you the real project too. And they say the following. We've investigated and determined that it doesn't violate our rules or community guidelines. Basically, them going in, them copying something. Again, they're not going to deliver on a project because this is a clone or a copy. It's just meant to steal money. Well, hey, that doesn't violate anything at all. If you believe there's an issue that's not covered by our rules and guidelines, please contact us with more details. If you haven't already, you can also communicate directly with the project creator. While we won't be taking action on this project at the time, we value your input. Yeah, I'm sure that you do. We rely on reports like yours to ensure the safety and integrity of Kickstarter to everyone. Integrity indeed. Thanks again for looking out. Best Kickstarter trust and safety. Oh, they'll ban you in a heartbeat if somebody calls you something nasty online. If they call you an N to the A to the Z to the I, or they say, ooh, you know what, kind of hate you back. But if you have something fake there, yeah, they won't back it. And like I said, to this Kickstarter, they need a video then. And that's what we're doing here. Now, as far as that idea, terms of services, this not being a violation goes, yeah, you and I will look at that in just a second. But before we do that, I want to show you how insidious this is. And the way to do that is, well, look at the original here, and then look at the copy. Again, copy that is Kickstarter bag, because baby, that ain't no violation. Now, if you look at this, you can tell right away that this thing is the original. How do you tell that? You can go to the creator. You can see that that creator has 6 campaigns all told. That would be this one plus 5 other campaigns. You know how many they've delivered on in the past? 100%. This person has a lot of backers here too for this. They've almost hit $10,000. Back that as well if you want to support this. I'll leave a link in the description. But yeah, if you look through it, again, everything is spot on here. Everything is legit. There is no warning sign whatsoever. When you get to this, though, well, you start noticing some problems. And a lot of those problems, they're not just surface level. When you dig a little bit deeper, yeah, you really notice some issues. Right off the bat, though, if you have somebody that has any profile whatsoever, 4 backers where you've gone into this many days, they only have 11 out of 30 days left, yeah, you have a problem. $115. There's an issue with that, though. When these 4 backers get scammed, you know who they're going to blame for it. They're not going to blame the scammer here. They're not going to blame Kickstarter. They're going to expect Vinny to actually make good on it. And you know what? What's crazy about that? Vinny actually probably would make good on it. If somebody scammed you out of some money, it was attached to my name, I would make good on it. And that's not right. You know who really needs to fix this? Kickstarter. Now, if you look at this, you look at how it's set up, right away, the ping here, the location, that should give everything away. This is the mark of a scammer. But then you get into this here. You see Vinny, this is the first created, never backed a project there either. And then when you look into it here, it's been copied. But if you look at who created this, that's interesting, isn't it? That's not Vinny who created his own project. No, that's a name that Vinny obviously doesn't know. The problem with these red flags is this. This here, a lot of people might not notice it. You see the location here under Vinny? Yeah, that actually disappears when we click the button. And you know what? We don't know where a lot of people are from on social media anyhow. This at the end of the day, too, it's not the consumer's responsibility. It's not the creator's responsibility. It's the platform's responsibility. But you saw there, they don't care. And that's exactly the way the Kickstarter acts. Now, as far as what this isn't violating, by the way, they mentioned 2 things. Terms of use, and they mentioned community guidelines. If we roll down through terms of use, your intellectual property, this is what I was mentioning at the beginning. All of this, it sets up deniability. The problem with deniability is that this idea is predicated on the notion that they don't know anything. You won't submit stuff you don't hold copyright for. You promise that if we use your content, we're not violating anyone's rights or copyrights. You're responsible for the stuff you post. We're not responsible for mistakes in your content. We are not responsible. Again, but that idea, that notion, it's predicated on the idea that they don't know about it. If you report that to them, those 4 people that are being scammed, yeah, how do they maintain deniability? Now, that other thing that they mentioned, community guidelines, it's based on the notion of seeing a problem and pointing it out. If you see something, say something. And you know what? If you didn't like somebody's politics on YouTube or Twitter, you could probably get them suspended. If you say, hey, they belong to that pesky hashtag Comicsgate, you could probably get somebody suspended. But if you point out fraud, you can't get anything done unless you shame them, and you shame them utterly. And that's why I'm asking people to share this. Share it loudly, share it proudly, because this should not stand. This is absolute trash. This impacts creators, it impacts consumers, and you know what? They won't do anything unless you make noise. So let's make noise together. But anyway, let me know what you think about this stuff, and as always, appreciate the heck out of you. You make this stuff work. Thank you. You want to back this channel too. There are links in the description. We have PayPal, Patreon, memberships, merchandise, and of course our comic book. The comic book, it shuts down at the end of this month. So yes, back it if you want to. Thank you. I appreciate you, and we'll see you soon.